Welcome back to Politics Watch. This is Serpy. Now, it appears the bull bay beef is getting hot. Get it? Bull bay beef. Anyway, this latest flare up in violence, because it's been going on for a while. You know, sometimes it appears various communities, it look like something now go on, and then you see two or three incidents back to back, and then people say, "Oh, the place I get hot, the place is always hot." It's just enough of these cases, enough of these beef things lay low for a while, right, bubbling on the surface, and then there's a huge spike, and then it drop. So this latest flare up in violence is linked to a murder that took place a couple days ago. You may remember the story on Monday, 22nd of March, where it was reported that a man losing his life in a wholesale downtown Kingston. That man was a 32-year-old Omar Clark, and he was described as a higgler from Bull Bay. Now here's the thing. Omar Clark wasn't just a higgler. He was also an area leader, a gang leader. See, Jamaica is a place where a man can be a higgler and a don and a runner of place. His street name, even a Bull Bay call him Duckmouth. That's him on your screen right now. And Duckmouth, he did a runoff. Because you see, if you understand, Bull Bay, especially 11 mile side, is a division. You have the Lane Gate man name, and you have the Tankwell man name. Duckmouth did a runoff, Lane Gate. Tankwell, well, the main player of the Tankwell is a youth named Bigger. Now you see, Duckmouth down a town selling his wares, because even though he's mixed up in the streets, well known, right? If you check into police and all them things, right? Well known on the scene, police don't know him very well, residents don't know him very well. Him still did a do him actual job. Because I say, you're a higgler. So, the man named Goffin. You know, for them things already. Right? Wholesale, customers are running up and down. Pure foolishness. That was a couple days ago. So now, you are here, say, two men lose them life now in Kiara Cashier Park. One of the youth them named Rico. He's a major player in the whole Bull Bay 87 scene. Right? Name called Pantings from how long. Matter of fact, you may remember a case that stretched all the way back to 2013 when the police found 18 guns over 1,000 rounds of ammunition. Yes, them same money link to that. So Rico, you can see him here screaming, so that's actually him behind bars. This is after the whole 18 guns thing, and you know, them name get called for other things, them get carrying, but you know it already. Bust the case, touched by the road. So Rico was back in the streets. When I see him crony them, youth named Curry, he's still behind bars. So Rico, them point him out as one of the people them who's responsible for what happened to Duckmouth, was me say, was the gang leader for the Lane Gate group of man them. So this is retaliation. And see which part it happened? Cashier Park. Look how far I catch a party from Bull Bay. Right. Trail him. Right. And, well, you know the rest. Right. Two of them end up losing life. Right. Thankfully, no random civilians never get caught in the foolishness. Right. Now, before we go any further on this, them man come from an era away, very close, right, to where Jasmine Dean used to live. The reason I mention this is because that era is a troubled era. And anytime any foolishness go on, the people them quick for Black Road and protest. And matter of fact, if you YouTube or Google 11 miles resident protest, you will see them out there. Protest, the 87s. Right. But Remember when Jasmine Dean family put on a protest there? How much people when they see turnout feet? I just wanted to drop that in as a friendly reminder. Right, you don't really want to what happened right now, but I just had to drop that in because more of the people them remember what we talk about. The whole fake walk, right, protest for justice, and say we don't believe you. Right. I just had to put that in there. Right. And if a police did kill Rico, if a police did kill Dartmouth, he'd have to protest from now until July, August, September, October, November, and all that 2022, then probably still out that ball. Just had to put that out there. Who vex us vex. So these men are the main violence producers over Bull Bay side. People them know them well, them history long. Police know them well. But you see, what took place with Dartmouth and now what happened to Rico is inevitably going to cause a spike, right, in the madness. Unless somehow the security forces them can squash it before it flare up. Because a two high ranking members on both sides, Dartmouth and now Rico. And if you understand, as usual, enough of them mana, or most of them mana used to link at one point, you know. You know, you're going at 87 life already. First them turn friend, then them turn frenemies, then them turn enemies. Right, so most of them used to link. Right. So you see, Tankwell. That place is interesting. Due to the location of Tankwell, it is very difficult for the police them running upon it. If you know that part of Jamaica, if you know 11 miles, you know it's very tricky, especially when you start getting at the real bushy part of them. So 87s know the game, you know. They know the game. So you notice them always embed themselves in some areas where police just can't swoop in quickly. Where them can't just turn up on a lane and pick up a man quickly. They have to drive up on track slow and then take their time, and by the time the police reach, residents don't call man and man take themselves, hide them gun and gone. Right, just like we see, right, in various other communities. So, when you see somebody like Rico, drop out like this, according to the rules of badness, somebody has to go dead back. Because you still want to Dartmouth. Dartmouth was Monday, right, 22nd. Just called it a day after, was Rico. So, before the week you finish, you might hear something else going on. Because Bull Bay man them, even though traditionally it's not a place where you constantly hear them name called right through the year, but Bull Bay, them are short of weapons. And them actually have whole heap of links with the same Haitian herbs for guns trade. That is how the whole 18, when the big find it going on with the 18 guns them, it was that same trade. So that is a dangerous combination. When you have an area where there's whole heap of weapons, obviously whole heap of 87s ready for use those weapons, then you have a location that is difficult for the security forces to navigate. And when you combine it with the fact that them know how to deploy for them kerosene very well, right? When you talk about lookout, because to the place set up, as I said, security forces can't just drive through anywhere they feel like. They can't only come to a certain point. And once them kerosene look out, send the word, that's it, man, them take out themselves. So people also wonder, how come things are going to Bull Bay and them can't catch their money and them can't catch their money? It's a system. There's a reason why most of these gangs call them operations system. West Kingston have for them system. Right. Clans have freedom system, one other freedom system, Bull Bay man them have freedom system too. Right. Highly effective system at that. Not just to carry out the ops, but to then escape, right, any sort of counter ops from the security forces. To be honest, I don't think we think the police are equipped to go really go up there, especially when I talk about Tankwell side. Right. I don't think they're equipped. That's probably going to be an ops for JDF, right? If the word gets sent on, if the call gets made. But right now, Bull Bay, people nervous. They're nervous because they know, say, when things flare up, and they multiply rifle, they get in the 87 hands, and man start answer back for this and retaliate back for this, they know it got ready. So I'm hoping the security forces can be as proactive as possible. Let me say it's difficult to navigate the place, but at the same time, still have to remember, say, people them need protection, the people them don't want to get caught in the middle. See, I have to remember, you know, no matter how acidic the community is, no matter how much agents in there work for the various actings, there is always people who don't want nothing to do with the crime and nothing to do with the violence. But in a certain place, in a quote-unquote bad man place, then people have to kind of keep their mouth quiet. Because unfortunately, even just condemning violence in Jamaica in certain communities might cost your life. Right? Matter of fact, in the same 11 miles it happened, you may remember a case happened recently with a farmer. Farmer tell man say, listen, low out them meat and stop part of them meat. People here care about news, just like that, man, lose them life. So these people, no, you don't have nobody to talk for them. Because you see, obviously the 87 and 90 in, you know, the community, obviously them have the protection because of them other things. The kerosene have the protection because a share lie down with the 87 and the 90. The relatives of the bad man them secure as well. But the people them who don't link sanitize, are them people lie down in them bed for the night time. And the strange thing is, it never used to always be like that, you know. Them places that used to be quiet one time. That's why I'm telling you, say, when you see a community, when you see 87s, or when you see the seeds that get sown for badness in our community, enough time when you think to yourself, I just have like a one man or two man, let me just know about that. We can probably help the police get them out, but just one and two, man, and major. One and two, man, spring up in a 50 within no time. It's like how plants use photosynthesis and grow. Me wonder if 87s use photosynthesis, because in time the sun, if you put two 87 in our community and make the sun touch them, that two 87 they blossom and bloom into 50 in no time. Yeah, I wonder where so much man come from. I wonder when the money start, but when the money start to go over here, so. Now for the place in Jamaica, we hot now. It was not long ago. Peaceful, peaceful place. Certain place in a Spanish town. Lariston and Tea Park and them places. These were once places where where your typical middle class come into where people just settle down and man go buy them house and things, and them go live peaceful, and next thing them know, them have to run with their feet. Run with their feet, 87 moving it and take it over. And so Bull Bay wasn't always like this. It wasn't, but you know, some serious 87s start the foolishness. Let me say, some youth like Raga, he's not in there again, but would be probably remember him. Corey, Zaza, Rico, him gone now. Doc Morton and him on there. Problem. But, look, let's see it play out. In an ideal world, the two sister man them would have said, well, you know what? Enough life has been lost. Enough death and destruction rain down upon the place, we could just call it a day. But we do not live in an ideal world, and let's be honest, that's not going to happen. So, what the people in Bull Bay, stay upon them P's and Q's. Watch out for your neighbor. Careful where you surround your neighbor, because they might go up and call their name to the man them. Tell them to them ESA. You have said the same, you said the man never left the place. And you can't bother, because they come mash up the community and them boy need to left. Just send them thing there. Man, cause if you lose your life in Jamaica. But despite the odds being against the people, and it seems like criminals about to overrun the island. We have to stay strong. We have to stay strong like the button in my Rico shirt. You see the button in my Rico shirt under pressure? Right. But them not give up. Them not pop. That's how the Jamaicans want to see the island make a turn around. Of all out. As me say, like your association, the CSS, the octane, the kerosene, they're up 32 points in the fourth quarter, but the game not done yet. I mean, the chances of victory look slim, but giving up while the game is still on, that's not an option. Because even if it might be too late for the generation we exist now, maybe the youth can come turn it around. That's why I noticed I focus so heavily, right, on children and how them grow and develop and what them turn into. Because if that generation is completely lost, then the game is over. Anyway, Patreon squad, big up on yourself. PIA, you don't know, more life. Vulture squad, stay circling. Bless.